Well, cool. So what we're going to do is we're going to solve this by completing the square. And so the first thing we want to do is, you know, a lot of times when we try to see this, we always want to look into factoring. But we notice that what two numbers multiply to give us 2, but then add to give us 4, nothing's that's going to work. The most we would have is 2 and 1, and that adds to 3, not to 4. So we're going to have to solve this by using a different method than factoring. And in this example, we're going to use completing the square. So when completing the square, remember, what we're going to do is we need to create a perfect square trinomial that we can factor down into a binomial squared. And the first important thing that we need to do is make sure we have our a is equal to 1, a positive 1, which in this case it is. Then I'll just apply some parentheses. And then inside those parentheses, what we need to do is create a perfect square trinomial. And remember, a perfect square trinomial is when your last term is a squared number. So therefore, we look at 2 and we say 2 is not a squared number. So this is not a perfect square trinomial. I need to create a constant inside this parenthesis that is going to be a square number. And to do that, I'm going to take my middle term b, divide it by 2, and then square it. And that's going to produce my square number that will produce a perfect square trinomial. So in this case, my b divided by 2, so b is 4 divided by 2. Square it. Well, 4 divided by 2 is 2. 2 squared is equal to 4. So therefore, I'm going to add a 4 inside my parentheses. Now remember, when solving a linear equation, whatever you do on one side, you always have to do on the other side. Well, when solving, we're going to do this exact same thing. Now I could add and subtract on the same side. That's the same thing. But for this case, I'm just going to show you, well, let's add them on both sides, because I want to solve for my x. So therefore, I'm going to have 0 equals x squared plus 4x. And now I'm going to add this inside my parentheses. So since I added on the right side, I'm going to add on the left side. And then I still have that positive 2. Well, this just becomes 4, right? Plus 4 plus 0, that becomes 4. We don't really need to write the 4. I could write that below. And then this x squared plus 4x plus 4, since that's a perfect square trinomial, the reason why we talked about perfect square trinomials is because they're very simple to factor. We can break this down into x plus 2 squared plus 2. And now you can see it's in this format, where now all I need to do is solve for this x by using my inverse operations. So I'll subtract 2 on both sides. I get 2 equals x plus 2 squared. Then I take the square root of both sides. And therefore, I have the square root of 2 equals x plus 2, just x plus 2. And then remember, when I take the square root, I have to make sure I introduce the positive and the negative, and then I'll subtract 2. Therefore, my final solution is x equals a negative 2 plus or minus the square root of 2. So there you go, ladies and gentlemen. That is how you solve the quadratic equation by completing the square. Thanks.